Hello everyone, as mentioned in the previous video, today we will talk about in more details how we met and also recalling our first date. So we are currently on our way to Montreal because this is where we met, and we're gonna visit the locations that we went during our first date. So I don't know if you're ready, but I am, so let's go! Montreal now, and it is freezing. We expected to walk a lot, but I think due to the temperature, not that much. So we're gonna go to the place where we first met. It used to be a Starbucks, it's not anymore, but we're gonna go to the exact place that he proposed to me.
Okay, let's go.
Yes, let's go.
Hello.
Hello. It said only minus 6. But we have a good wind.
Wow.
It actually feels colder.
It's so pretty inside.
Harsa.
Wow.
What is it? The cannabis coffee.
Okay, this one. I remember.
Yeah, okay, you're right, I guess.
Yeah, I wanted to come in. And I was like, it's closed. I was like, why the hell did he insist that we go to Starbucks? Because it was past midnight.
네, 여기가 스타벅스였는데 현재는 밖에 있는 상태.
Yeah, it was right.
원래는 밖에 좀 돌아다니면서 저희가 처음 만났던 장소 뭐 이런 걸 보여드리려고 그랬는데 날씨가 너무 추워서.
Yes.
날씨가 너무 추워서 지금 이제 아마 실내에 들어가서 좀 얘기를 해야 될 것 같아요. 밖에가 너무 추워서. 네, 그럼 이따 뵙겠습니다.
My hands hurt.
그래서 드디어 몬트리올에 도착했습니다. 도착해서 날씨가 너무 추워서 그냥 간단하게 밥 먹고 그 이제 나름 조용한 데를 찾았는데 그게 영상에 잘 촬영될지 모르겠네요. 그래서 이제 저희에 대해서 한번 설명하자면 How long have we been together?
Oh boy, counted it in the car. So I know that in April we're gonna hit 7 years of marriage. We actually started to date in October 2016. 7 years?
More than 7 years, I would say.
Yeah, because you proposed to me just 3 months into the relationship.
So 저의 얘기를 간단하게 하자면 저는 한국에서 살고 중학교, 고등학교 때 공부를 너무 안 해서 부모님이 저를 이제 유학을 보냈어요, 뉴질랜드로. 그래서 고등학교 생활을 뉴질랜드에서 하고 그리고 또 안 좋게 한국을 다시 돌아가서 지방대에 들어가고 그리고 군대를 갔다가 갔다 와서 이제 정신 차리고 그때부터 공부를 시작해서 대학교를 이제 편입하고 그러고 IT 중견기업에 입사를 해서 한 3년 동안 일을 하다가 야근의 강도가 되게 심했거든요. 제가 유일하게 주말만 바라보면서 회사 생활을 했던 이유가 야구를 되게 좋아했었어요. 근데 이제 주말에도 출근하는 상황도 오고 하다 보니까 자연스럽게 이제 제가 뉴질랜드 생활을 하면서 느꼈던 그 자유로움, 플렉시블한 그런 스케줄을 뉴질랜드 현지인들이 그렇게 생활을 했었으니까 그래서 그런 게 되게 그리웠었어요. 그래가지고 회사 생활을 한 2년 정도 하면서 이제 느꼈던 게 한국에 있으면 안 되겠다. 결국에는 캐나다로 이제 이민을 오게 되었어요. 이민을 오고 나서 이제 처음 생각했던 게 제가 뭐 유학생활을 했을지언정 영어가 많이 부족했었거든요. 그래서 캐나다 왔으니까 이제 현지인 여자친구를 만들어서 영어도 도움이 되고 그리고 이제 더 나아가서 결혼도 할 수 있겠다 뭐 이런 생각을 했었거든요. 그래서 캐나다 오자마자 저는 소개팅 어플을 한 3, 4개 돌리면서 캐나다 여자친구를 찾았죠. 그러다가 이제 얻어 걸린 게 여기. 그렇게 해서 이제 만나게 됐던 게 이제 여기까지 왔네요. 그래서 7년이 지났어요.
My background. Yeah. Well, if you have watched the second video of the channel, so I am originally from Quebec City. I was on the same dating app as Haun, obviously. And for me, Montreal was not that far, so my search filters included Montreal because for me, I didn't mind making the move like if I really ended up liking a guy. Basically, what happened is I looked up new profiles. Like there was a feature like newest profiles and Haun popped up. I looked at his profile. Obviously he mentioned that he's from South Korea and he's new in the country, looking to meet people here. From his pictures I was like, okay, he's a good looking guy. What I liked is that it seemed simple, not the type of guy that, you know, like showed himself like, you know, shirtless in the mirror like, hey, look at me, how good I look, you know. I had good vibes from him. He was like, he had a nice smile on his picture. I was like, okay, no, he looked like someone that is like down to earth. I don't know, I just had good vibes. I have female intuition. So I was like, okay, that's going to be new, probably going to be a language barrier because I didn't really expect him to speak French, obviously, because he's new. One of the first questions I have asked you is, are you here for immigration or you're like a foreign student? Because at that time, I did not want to, you know, look up to, you know, meet a guy and like, I was like looking for something more or less serious in the sense that I was not really dare to meet my future husband, though I did. Don't want to get attached to someone if that person ends up going back. That's why I have to make sure, okay, what are you, your plan are to immigrate to Canada, you're gonna stay in Canada. So that was like my first like hit or miss. So yeah, if I recall correctly, I am the one that started to talk to you first, right?
I guess.
I think so. We're not that much of a big talker on the chat, and you still is not. Yeah, I think we waited until I was going to Montreal. I planned to meet Haun because why not? I was like, I'm gonna take a chance. At that time, I was like, if it doesn't work, I'm gonna take a break. I'm gonna remove my profile and just, you know. So basically, Haun was the last chance.
Last chance.
At that time, we were like vocational school. We planned to meet at very big subway station called Beryukan. At the time, I had a lot of time to kill before he finishes his class. So I go on my way. There was this Starbucks. Went into that Starbucks and I was like, okay, I'm gonna kill some time there until it's done. But then someone comes into the Starbucks and guess who?
Because I also had to kill some time because I arrived early.
Okay, so that's what happened.
Yeah.
So we really absolutely did not plan to meet at that Starbucks. It's just I saw him coming and I was like,
because even though we met from the app, we still knew each other's face.
Yeah, it was not a blind date. So I recognized him and I think, yeah, our eyes met. You recognized me, obviously. We were like, oh, hi. His English and my English were not as good as today. Because of course, like, you know, we've been together for like around 7 years-ish. So it's because of our relationship that we are speaking English every day. So it's just natural that our English has improved with the time.
저는 그 이민을 결심을 하고 이제 처음 왔던 도시가 여기 몬트리올이었어요. 처음에 어차피 이제 이민자가 이제 처음 시작하면서 이제 비자를 받을 수 있는 계기가 뭐 학생 비자 아니면은 뭐 워크 퍼밋 이런 거라서 일단 저도 이제 어쩔 수 없이 다시 학생으로 돌아갔었죠.
I also just little thing. What I liked about the fact that you are from South Korea and you just ended up here means that all of your past exes were all there, so you come here fresh. So for him, I was like, that's just a little plus. Both for him and for me, it is our first relationship that is outside of our culture. So basically, I'm the first not Korean woman that he's with, and he is my first not Quebecois man.
That is true.
It was basically like, you know, very new for us, coupled with the language exchange. Like, it's not like, for example, a Korean guy that was born and raised in Canada that speak perfect French, or like I've been adopted, because there are South Koreans adopted in Quebec. Was really like just arrived.
I'm FOB.
Exactly, he's an FOB.
Yeah, at that time we were both young, so we were like pretty open-minded to seeing or experiencing different perspective of culture.
At that time I was very young, I was 24. Mm-hmm. And you were 28. At first I was like, 28, it seems old. So in my mind I was more expecting to meet guy like that was around my age, but I was like, okay, 28, that's a bit old, but I will give it a shot. But now that I think about it, 28 is not old.
Let's talk about the place where we met for the first time.
The Starbucks?
Yeah, so today we went there, but apparently the Starbucks is no longer there.
But the building is still there. I recognize the platform that we stepped on to have the proposition.
Yeah, we met October 2016.
Yes.
And we had like a 3 months of relationship. And after that, January 2017, I decided to just propose right away.
That's
after 3 months of a relationship.
Yes, idea.
Yeah, so at the same time, for New Year's 2017, we went to Old Montreal just to see the fireworks.
Yeah, I have to mention that at that time we were not living together. I was still in Quebec City because I was a student. Every weekend I traveled to Montreal to see him, that crappy apartment he lived in.
So I think I decided to propose her after 2 months-ish of a relationship.
Jeez.
So I prepared everything. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna propose her on New Year's at the Starbucks, which is the place that we met for the first time. So after seeing the fireworks for the New Year 2017, I just told her to let's go to Starbucks for no reason. Even though like it was like after midnight, so it's gonna be for sure closed. But probably she was suspicious at that time.
At first I was a bit oblivious, but I was like, this was past midnight. Why the hell do you wanna go to Starbucks? So I was like, okay, let's go, I guess.
So we went there. Of course, the Starbucks was closed.
Yeah.
And I just started to speak in French with a like romantic sentence and so on.
You never did it after. It was just one time. Yeah, like basically he put himself on one knee. The classic proposal.
I showed her the ring after midnight at the entrance of that Starbucks.
Yes.
At the time, like there were a lot of people hanging around, so
of course.
Yeah, some people saw us, saw me doing proposing, so people say, yeah.
It was a moment.
Yeah, it was a moment that we cannot forget.
Absolutely.
We struggled a lot to find that exact spot because Starbucks was no longer there.
Exactly.
And it was like long time ago memory, right? So it was hard to catch up. So we ended up finding the right place. Reminded us of a good memory. I always kept pointing at the wrong place, but she got it right.
He didn't believe me at first. After that, he's like, oh, it's so long. Because you are always like double guessing, or like who's like not trusting my instinct.
So do you remember what I said?
Damn, it's so long ago. I cannot. I just remember one time. I don't know if it was either the proposal or like the one cute Christmas card that you wrote in French, and you said you did a misspell. You wanted to say I had a crush, but you translated to the version where crush means literally to crush. So when I read it, I was like, oh, that's cute. I mean, French is a hard language, but I give all credit to him.
Yeah, I had to prepare a script, and then I have to like keep reading so that I can remember. Yeah, I ended up like speaking French in a proposal.
You were learning French at that time too.
Proposal.
Oh yeah. So I said yes. Of course, I absolutely did not expect that, because 3 months. 3 months is very short. It's short, like for my standards, what I am used to in my culture. But I think in a lot of cultures, it's short. I said yes.
What did you say yes?
Why I said yes?
Yeah, after only 3 months of relationship.
I don't know. It felt right. I was very, very much in love. Very in love with that man. So at that time, I was like, it feels right. I guess my gut feeling was right because we're still together. But of course, my parents were like, that's fast. They listened to their heart. What about you? Why did you propose to me?
Yeah, that's why I still wonder why I did that.
What do you regret? I had very bad sense of style at that time.
In Korea, like meeting your girlfriend's parents is like a big deal.
That's
of course, a stereotype. Oh, Asian?
So they can have the green card.
Ta-da!
Hello!